We are tempering hybrid striped bass here at Cedar Creek Reservoir. We have 84,400 in this truck right here for Cedar Creek Reservoir. And there's actually another truck coming with probably about the same amount, be here in about an hour.
That is a bunch of fish. The idea here is that this is a species that does not reproduce itself. These are actually produced in the hatchery using the eggs of the striped bass and using the milt of the white bass. They're combined in the hatcheries, and we're trying to make these hybrid stripers. And the advantage of the hybrid striper is that that way we have total control over the numbers of fish that are out there. We can match our stocking rates to the amount of forage that's in a particular body of water. Typically, we'd be using the sonar to find concentrations of fish if we were fishing. But today, we're trying to find areas of the lake that don't have any predatory fish. We want to turn these fish, turn these little fingerlings loose in a place they've got the best chance of survival. So we're going to be watching for schools of white bass or anything else that might eat these little fellows, and we're going to try to avoid them any way that we possibly can. Because we do have so much open water habitat, and because we have such a really good shad population out here, we can support this other predator. And the other predator that we're using in this case is the palmetto bass, or what is commonly called the hybrid striped bass. And it's a species that a lot of anglers don't really understand. There's angler perception that the hybrid stripers compete with largemouth bass. Well, it's not a competition issue, it's a reacting to the habitat that's out here issue. We know we can't produce largemouth bass, we don't have the vegetation to do that, but we've got a lot of open water habitat that's real good for the shad and real good for the hybrid stripers. And then again, because it's a hybrid that doesn't reproduce itself naturally, we've got total control over the numbers that are out here. If we have a year where we have very high production of shad and a very abundant forage base, we can increase our stocking rate to take advantage of that. If, on the other hand, we have atmospheric conditions that limit the production of forage, limit the production of prey, we can temporarily curtail stocking of the hybrid stripers, so we won't run into a situation where we have more fish out here than we can feed.
Once we get out here, we'll start looking at the graph and we'll look for bait balls, or we'll look for other schools of the existing predators. And if we see them, we'll just leave this area and go somewhere else. Right now, what I'm seeing is mostly open water. We know we've got this good green color that indicates to us that we've got a real good phytoplankton bloom. That phytoplankton bloom is what's going to support the zooplankton bloom, and the zooplankton are what are going to feed these little hybrids.
You ready here?
Yeah. So what's going to happen is Jake's going to start releasing these fish.